Recording. We are recording.
My outfit this week is, I might be 28, but I can still pretend to be 18. What's this? Oh, what's this? I may have been going through work clothes and found some old ribbon that I intend on playing with this entire intro / outro. This is kind of choking me. I'm not mad about it. So this week's video, it's a video.
Curious.
There's some dill holes doing construction right out there. So if you hear that, your life's not that hard. Calm down.
This week's video.
This week's video, I'm making some shorts. My inspo. It's hot out and I end up wearing this one pair of shorts almost constantly around my house. These, you know, they're cute and everything. They're cute, but they get dirty because I'm filthy. I'm a filthy person. And then I need new shorts. I'm making some nice casual, just lay around the house pajama shorts. In short, pajama shorts. I haven't done anything just for my bottom half yet. You know, I've made some dresses. I've made a bodysuit. I've made a dunny. But those were all for more so this part of my body than my butt part of my body.
I'm so strong.
The sweet thing about these shorts is if you ever have like extra fabric, it doesn't take that much, especially if you make them as short as I did, but it doesn't take that much extra fabric to make them. So if you just have some like scrap material around, then you can have yourself a little pair of cute shorts. Oh my god, this stuff stretches. Okay. Does anybody need any flagging? That's the industry term for it. So if you live in an area that loves getting humid AF, Ontario, hey, then maybe you'll enjoy yourself a little pair of PJ shorts. I don't have anything else to say. I'm just making shorts. For this project, I already had an existing pattern for a pair of shorts that I made about a year ago. However, I do want to make a few modifications to it. First, the previous pair was high-waisted, but I want my PJ shorts to sit around my hips. To have them lie at my hips, I would need to take away 5 inches from the top, but I want to add a waistband and I like to err on the side of caution, so I'm only going to take away 3 inches. For the legs, I have about 4 extra inches of fabric on this design because I folded them up not once, but twice. The floral shorts are hella short though, so to make sure that the pajama shorts reach at least my crotch, I'll only remove 2 inches from the pattern. For the pajama shorts, I will be using leftover round fabric from a previous project. This is the original pattern, and to be honest, I'm not sure what was fully going on, but I'm not going to dwell on that. I wasn't sure how to go about using this pattern to make a new one. My original plan was to trace it and then cut down from there, but it looks like this stupid thing won't fit onto my piece of paper. I measured 3 inches down at the top of the pattern piece and folded it down, and that seemed to help it fit. There's a little bit at the crotch that won't fit, so I folded that in as well and will trace it after, then tape it on. I traced the rest regularly and came out with a shape-like shape. I remember having to take in the shorts a bunch, so I'm going to remove an inch from the side so that I don't run into that problem as much. I know I'll probably have to take them in a bit, but with sewing, more is generally better. Then, I took 2 inches off the bottom. For that crotch piece, I traced a line before unfolding it and then used the same measurements as before for the modifications. When I was done, the piece of paper was such a small amount, it felt stupid, but I had already gone so far, so I taped it on and continued living my life. Always remember to properly label your patterns. I marked the fold, but guess what? I shouldn't have. You'll see. I had a bunch of scrap pieces of paper, so I did another Franken job and customized this piece so the pattern would fit no prob. I repeated all of the things for the back pattern piece. When all of that is done and your pieces are cut out, make sure that the lengths of everything are somewhat matching up. You know what I call this? I call this good enough. Straight fabric can be a bit of a B word to work with. That is, if you're a person that has the time to give a shoot. Do your best to match the stripes up and keep them in line when you are cutting the fabric, but don't have a crap attack if it's not perfect. I like to pin my fabric in half because I am not kidding around when it comes to cutting. I also pin my pattern to the fabric because I am really not kidding around. Make sure you place your pattern so that the stretch will go correctly with your garment. Then cut it out. Try to set up your back pattern piece so that it will somewhat match your front one, stripe-wise. I did not do it right. Learn from me. I guess I must have placed the back piece on a spot that I'd already cut a little, so when I opened it up, this was there. I think I should be able to hide it though with the waistband, and like I said before, knowing me, I will have to cut away a bunch of material anyway. So as I previously said, I made the last pair of shorts about a year ago, and I really wanted to see if I could remember how to do it without looking it up. And believe me, I really did try. Really. But I also had other shit to do, so I ended up looking up the next step and discovered at least partially why I was so confused. I wasn't supposed to cut them out on a fold. Basically, I am supposed to have four separate cutouts, but two pairs that match. I folded the pieces back in half, pinned them so they wouldn't move around, and cut very carefully along the fold. Once you have four separate pieces, place a bottom piece on a front piece, right sides facing together, and sew along that crotch bit. Then, when that is done, open up your recently sewn pieces and place them on top of one another, right sides together. Pin it so your seams match up and are open, and then sew along the U. Once all that is done, when you open it up, it should actually be starting to look like shorts. I somehow managed to figure things out after this point. Fold it so that your right sides are together yet again. Pin the sides and sew. Now, can you guess what happened when I put them on? They were shockingly way too big. I had more than enough fabric on top and had to take in a healthy amount at the sides. I rolled down the top until it was where I wanted it to fall on my hips and threw a few pins in to mark it. Then I pinned along the sides. I had to readjust the pins a few times to make sure I was taking in enough because I didn't want to have to take in more again. The legs look a little long, but I'm going to wait until I've made the other adjustments to see if I need to shorten them. Now, I really should have tried on the garment while it was inside out so that my pins wouldn't be on the wrong side for sewing this bish. It probably would have been easier to take out the pins, turn it inside out, try it on again, and repin. But I didn't want to. Instead, I drew a chalk line down the pin seam, and it actually turned out pretty accurate. I repinned and then sewed along this line. To make sure I took the same amount in on the other side, I pinned the garment in half and then placed pins right along the stitch I had just did. I flipped it over and used the pin line to make a chalk line and then showed it up. When I put the shorts on this time, they actually fit. I readjusted the waist because I found that I wanted it lower than I had previously marked and made sure the line was clean from the front to the back. Because the shorts fit, I felt confident in cutting away the excess fabric from the sides. I chalked up the waistline as well. I measured up an inch and a half from my chalk line because the elastic band is an inch wide, and I added a half inch for seam allowance. I cut along the top line I made, one side at a time. Although it would have been easier to do both at once, in case they were slightly different heights, I didn't want to do both at the same time. I first measured out the waist length using the shorts themselves and took away an inch to make it tight. When I put that length around my waist, I hated it. I instead found a tightness that I felt comfortable with. These are supposed to be loungewear, so why in the hell would I have them overly tight? Then I pinned that in place. To make sure that the waistband wouldn't snap, I sewed a box shape and then across through that box. Section out the waistband in quarters. Start by halving it and marking each side with a pin. And then half it the other way and mark it with pins again. I placed my waistband directly underneath my waist chalk line and lined up my pins with the seams before folding the fabric over and pinning in place. Repeat with all four seams. I only pinned these four spots so that when I was sewing the waistband in place, I could stretch the fabric to fit. This is the only time I recommend pulling on your garment while sewing. And I'm not even confident I was supposed to do it in this case. But because my waistband wasn't much of a different length than the shorts waist, it wasn't really a huge problem. Make sure you're sewing right on the edge of the waistband elastic. I iron the waist afterward to give it a cleaner edge. When I last tried the shorts on, I liked the length of the legs and actually didn't want them much shorter, so I wanted a small hem. I did a half inch hem that turned into almost a quarter inch in some spots. But, of course, when I tried them back on, the hem looked so stupid. The fabric kept trying to roll when I was sewing it, and I think I had too small a stitch with too high of tension. I used a zigzag stitch, and I had originally set it at a tension of 4 and a width and length of 3. I stitched up the hem, changed the hem length to 1 inch, and set my machine at a tension of 3 with a stitch width and length of 4. And when I was done, they no longer looked horrendous. And that's everything, guys.
Man. Shorts are so comfortable. I feel like I could fall asleep just about anywhere.
This guy died. Damn. Come here.
Come here. You little bitch.
Welcome back to long pauses and deep sighs. How did you guys enjoy the shorts? Would you like yourself a little pair of shorty shorts to wear around your house? So, if you had a good time, please like this video. This is gonna turn into porn. Give it a big thumbs up if you had a good time and if you like my content. Please subscribe. Please subscribe. If you don't subscribe, then I won't be able to keep doing things like this. Follow me on the socials. Follow me on the socials. I'm on Instagram and Facebook. I've been thinking about getting Twitter. Because, like, I hate it. But the idea is just, like, putting my random... The idea of putting my random spastic thoughts seems really funny to me, or mildly entertaining. Recommend my content to all your friends and family. They won't be offended. Let's move on. Tune in next week where I do something else that's really stupid. Oh, actually, next week's gonna be real stupid, so tune in. If you have anything you want me to make, comment. Leave me a little comment. I'll probably make it. It's me, let's be serious. I think up until this point, there's probably a few of you that are like, that's hot. So I'm happy I'm ruining it for you, you sick f***. This can't be sanitary. All right, my sweet precious daffodils. I'll see y'all next week.
It's a good look, I think.